much that. Now, we have a cafe bar facility on the boat. There are things like tea or coffee. Available £1.50 each. Hot chocolate, Galaxy hot chocolate, £2. There are cans of fizzy drinks. That'll be Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, and lemonade. They're £1.50 each. And, well, cartons of orange juice, bottles of mineral water for £1. Now, if you fancy something stronger, we've got chilled bottled Carlsberg beer. There's also a South African dry white wine, which is chilled, and by the medium bar, that's 175 mil. We can do pins with all the trimmings, and we can also do chocolate or coffee with Bailey's Irish cream liqueur. Now, all of the alcoholic drinks, no matter what it is, £3 each. And if you use the order, will be brought to where you sit. Got to come round in any case to collect the fares. They're £8 for adults, £6 for old age pensioners, £6 if you have a current and valid student card, and £4 for children under 16. But if you've got the right money, we'll make things easy. I'm a bit short on credit at the moment. Now, I shall be leaving you in peace on the way upstream, taking the kite to town to the river. On the way back down, I'll offer you a brief, unintrusive commentary. Just pointing out that you can reach out at the moment. Well, the weather's a bit iffy today. It'll eventually be sunny by now. But if you're on the top deck, where of course you get the best view across the ocean valley, and you felt you were too exposed to the elements, well, feel free to make your way downstairs to the covered cabin. In other words, make yourself comfortable, sit back, relax, and enjoy the trip.
小船一名，竟然让女生滑，
全部人都在讲这件事
情。嗨，Hello。 对，不过坐在上面是看更高一点，看得到窗，这边只看得到草而已啊，是不是？
那可以再上去啊。
对啊，我觉得应该要上去的。
不是椅子是这样，只是椅子是细的。
哦，它怪不得要做成两层，要让你看上面呢。
To deepen the river because they had working water wheels situated over there behind where the weir is now. And by deepening the river, well, they ensured that their wheels would be sat sufficiently in a volume of water to keep turning all the year round, even during any dry summer months when the river level could drop quite dramatically. So whenever you see a weir like that anywhere in the country, you can be sure at one time or another there were water wheels not too far away.Against the podium. Right, just ahead of us is an already clad building, gold lettering, that lettering the Gomelino Cafe Bar and Restaurant. That building was put up in 1926 on the site of an old flour mill that stood there before. It was a large stone and timber structure.After all, maybe even five times the size of the building we see there now. A very important building it was too for the village. Back in those days, an old painting to cross that bridge in the park was carried. Now, despite being trees from the back end, it's true that they know that the city centre is that the school is turned up by the way. Despite this, we want to thank you for this. These days, we come.
好近哦！阿轩，妈咪。
Again. A would be the most perfect river or waterway you could find on the planet. G, leave that to your imagination. In this country there are no grade A rivers. Thankfully there are grade B rivers here. There are seven of these grade Bs. That means, well, it's safe to swim in. It shores a wide range of wildlife too. 32 species of freshwater fish. Many different birds, among them grey herons, kingfishers.And after an absence of almost 60 years, well, we got otters back too. The rest of the Stone Age.
seen a couple of archaeological sites from that era. And of course, moving into the late Stone Age or Neolithic, the evidence of human activity is very, very clear, although at first it may not be so obvious. You see, it was those people that deforested the land. That's why we have all the fields around the south of England today. They cleared the way for farming. They wanted to make charcoal, that sort of thing.
Up away on that hill behind the TV mark. And of course, the latter phase of Stonehenge was completed in the Bronze Age. But human activity becomes more prolific, very evident when we get into the Iron Age, the Celtic Iron Age. In around 600 BC. And in fact, that's when the first seeds of the town of Bath were first sown. Story goes, it's the story of the Celtic king, King Bradud. Now, he's supposed to have examined Shakespeare's King Lear. But anyway, one day he had a terrible disease, leprosy. And the elder subjects of his kingdom felt he must be cursed by the Celtic goddess Sulis. Well, he would have to be exiled he was, forced to wander the wilderness with nothing but pigs and company, because he took up employment as a swineherd. Well, in time, those unfortunate pigs, they picked up his skin disease, and then one day they happened upon the hot springs where the city centre now stands. Well, the Baths became a very famous view of the Saxons. Later on, the Vikings and the Romans all came over. Now, the area around the Baths stayed pretty much Saxon for centuries. They expanded the town of the Georgian times, from early 17th to early 1800s. Georgian society was lucky enough to enjoy the luxury of three public baths, making use of those hot springs. They were very popular affairs too. People would come from far and wide, not just this country, but across the continent of Europe, China now. Well, when you walk around the modern city of Bath, the most common feature probably is the architecture from the Georgian period. It still pretty much is a Georgian town. The architectural style is known as Palladian. That's after the great Italian architect Andrea Palladio, born in Venice in 1509. He was responsible. You can while away the hours with a glass of wine watching people come to terms.
Thank you very much indeed.